Welcome to Plum Landing! Roots and shoots!
Today, we're on a mission for Plum.
We are making sponge models of plants
so we can see how plants in the desert keep water inside of them.
I'm trying to make a cactus out of a green sponge.
My plant looks like a four-legged monster.
This is my plant I made. It has roots, it has a stem, and it has leaves. Plants in the desert need to be able to collect and hold the water.
I think plants in the desert need to be really thick so they can store water for a long time because it doesn't rain a lot there.
We want to try putting skin on some of our sponge plants with the wax paper
to create a waxy skin for some of our plants.
Because the leaves on many kinds of desert plants have a waxy skin like this.
But I left the roots open so the roots can draw the water in.
I am not going to put any wax paper on my leaves or my stem or my roots.
Kiana also made a cactus-shaped plant.
I added toothpicks so that my cactus would stand up like a real cactus.
First, we put our sponge plant on a plastic plate. Then we poured a quarter cup of water around the plant.
We can see water getting soaked up in the sponge.
We poured off the leftover water. Now we're gonna leave our sponge plant out overnight and come back tomorrow and see what they look like.
And the sponges, they look like they've dried out a bit.
The water evaporated.
Evaporation happened even though there was no sun.
I am now going to remove the skin from mine. This part that was covered with the skin, it's wetter because the skin kept it from evaporating. But when I feel the roots that weren't covered in the skin, they feel dry.
The part of my cactus that is under the skin feels wetter than these parts.
My desert plant, because it wasn't wrapped up in a really cool skin like Kalea's, it is dry now.
This is my cactus that was standing up. The whole cactus is wet. Maybe it's because it was all covered up. Even though it was standing up, the water went up, up, up into the cactus. It's a lot like the real cactuses in the desert.
Explore your world and then tell Plum about it at the Plum Landing site at pbskids.org.